Hello everybody. So we will be doing two experiments together because the circuit is same for both these experiments, but the procedure is different. The experiments that I am talking about is sampling and pulse amplitude modulation, also known as PAM. What is sampling? Basically, when we are thinking of sampling, we have to consider a switch. Now, as shown in this figure, we have an input signal which passes through the switch and we get an output signal. Now when the switch is open, no signal passes through, so we don't get any signal at the output, which is shown by this very light representation of the signal. Now suppose at time t0 we close the switch. So as shown here, at time t0 when the switch was closed, the input signal traveled to the output of the switch and we start getting the output. We get the output until we keep the switch closed, and once the switch is opened again, we stop getting the signal at the output. So all in all, when we close the switch for a time period of t1 minus t0, we get a pulse at the output whose amplitude is basically dependent on the input signal itself. Thus, what we have done is we have taken a sample of a signal. So the sampling of a signal requires a switch which can be controlled using a pulse waveform which will bring this switch to on and off position. So once the pulse is there, the switch is closed, we get the signal at the output. Once we get the zero portion of the pulse waveform, the switch is as good as off and we get nothing. Thus, when we keep all the signals in the same time period, what we see is that those portion of the analog signal in which the pulse waveform is having high, we get the sampled analog signal at the output of the switch. This is also the same concept of pulse amplitude modulation or PAM, wherein the message signal is converted into the amplitudes of the pulse. As you can see here, the pulse waveform have the same amplitude, but the PAM output will have its amplitude changed according to the magnitude of the analog signal. Now the sampling theorem is based on the Nyquist criteria, which says that the frequency of sampling, which is basically given by Fs, which is 1 by t, t being the time period with which the pulse is being repeated. This sampling frequency should be greater than or at least equal to twice the maximum message frequency of the analog signal that is being given at the input. Thus, if we follow the Nyquist criterion says that we will be able to reconstruct this analog signal back from this sampled signal. If we do not follow the Nyquist criteria, we will not be able to get the analog signal back. So in the experiment of sampling of a signal, we will try to see or check if the Nyquist criteria is true or not. Whereas in the experiment of PAM, we will be interested only to get this pulsed amplitude modulated wave at the output. We will not be checking if the Nyquist criteria is being satisfied or not, because for the PAM experiment, we will already take care that the Nyquist criteria is satisfied. For doing this experiments, we will be using ICCD4016 as a switch. As you can see in this internal diagram, CD4016 has four switches, namely SWA for switch 1, SWB the second switch, SWC the third switch, and SWD the fourth switch. We'll be using only switch A, and the input signal will be given at pin number 1. The controlled pulse signal will be given at pin number 13, and the output will be obtained at pin number 2. The other three switches will not be used by us in this experiment. This is the circuit diagram. As I told you earlier, the circuit diagram will be same for PAM as well as sampling theorem. Now, for sampling, the instruction, you can see it in burgundy color here, whereas for PAM experiment, the instruction given is in black. So for the PAM or the sampling theorem, we use CD4016, the first switch of that particular IC, wherein the input is given at pin number 1, the output is obtained at pin number 2, and the clock signal, which is basically the pulse waveform, is given at pin number 13. For the case of PAM, we will take care that the Nyquist criteria is satisfied by taking care that the pulse waveform frequency is more than twice the frequency of the input signal that we are giving here. For our experiment, we will take the input signal to have a frequency of 1 kHz sinusoidal signal. The VCC, we will use 10 volt. Pin number 7 is going to be grounded, and we will get the PAM output, or in the case of sampling, we will get the sampled signal at the output. For the case of sampling experiment, we will have three different conditions of the pulse waveform, wherein we will give one frequency which is very, very low than the Nyquist criteria, the second frequency which is closer to the Nyquist criteria, slightly greater than the Nyquist criteria, and the last one will be when it is very, very larger than the Nyquist criteria, which we also called as oversampling. So we'll get a sample signal with too many samples in the case of oversampling, too little samples in the case of undersampling, and we will do our study based on them. The PAM demodulator is used for getting the input signal or the modulated input signal back at the output. For the case of sampling, this is basically a reconstruction filter or a low pass filter. The design of this requires a value of R and C to be found. Since it's a low pass filter, we'll be using the frequency cutoff equation to be 1 by 2 pi RC, where the cutoff frequency will be chosen such that it is higher than the message frequency, which was 1 kHz, and much lower than the sampling frequency, which we are taking, let's say, 5 kHz for the case of sampling theorem. Let us take F to be 2 kHz. For this equation, we will assume C to be 0.01 microfarads. Thus, we will use the same circuit for both the experiments. Thank you.